wrote implicit function with an example before definition. So I'll start the definition and then look at an example. So implicit function is a function. Function of the form. F of x, y equals 0. But x cannot be explicitly determined by y. And y cannot be explicitly determined by x. Yeah, I could. So it's valid to ask you what's the definition of something, whether it's implicit function. But generally, I'll try to make a bigger deal about the definitions that are more important that I would directly ask you about. Like in calculus, that would be definition of derivative, definition of limit. That's the main two definitions that I can think of that were themselves super important. I mean, there's plenty of other definitions too, but those are the big ones. These are not as big like those are. All right, so an implicit function is one that you can't write y in terms of x or x in terms of y. So it's very much the exact opposite of wherever that last region. Function of one independent variable. So we start out with two variables are related by an equation, but you cannot solve for one variable in terms of the other, and vice versa. So it's the opposite of function of one independent variable. So you wouldn't be able to solve for one of the two. So we'll do an example of an implicit function. We'll take something easy. So we'll have f of x, y equals x squared plus y squared minus 25 equals 0. So there's our function, x squared plus y squared minus 25, and it equals 0. Now, technically, you could expand the definition so they don't have to equal 0. They can just equal any number, and you just subtract that number to the other side. So what does this equation represent? Circle. What's the radius?
5.
So you add 25 to the other side, and I'll go with the triple equal sign. So we could write it like this, 5 squared. So that's the standard form of a circle. Now if I try to solve for y all the way, we have y equals plus or minus square root 5 squared minus x squared. So what I can't do is say y is determined by x. If you tell me x, I know plus or minus y, but I don't know y explicitly. So we can say y cannot be uniquely determined by x. And likewise, x cannot be uniquely determined by y. Now, if you graph this, what would it look like? A circle, and it doesn't pass the horizontal or a vertical line test. So that's another way, graphically, if you have a graph of the equation, if it doesn't pass the vertical line test, it's not a function of x, and doesn't pass the horizontal line test, you can't write it as a function of y. So we're ready to go into the next section, which we will do properly, the differential equation. So we start out with a definition of equation, and then maybe we started with, I think we had definition of differential equation. It's equation with variables and their derivatives and how they're all related. So we got that definition. So we're going to look at ordinary differential equations. So we saw a definition for differential equations, so we'll focus on the word ordinary. So these will be relations of variables and their derivatives, but not partial derivatives. So these will be variables and their derivatives are related, but not partial derivatives. So what do you think differential equations are called if you allow partial derivatives?
Partial
differential equations. So that's another course you could take. All right, we are not going to do that. All of our derivatives are going to be of the same variable. So we may have a time, an equation that takes ddt's. You see how things change over time. That's the problem we just did, that one differential equation we solved had a ddt in it, or dx dt. So our differential equations will either be ddt, ddx, another very popular one. Occasionally there may be another variable we're taking a derivative with respect to, but it would generally be with respect to x or t. So we don't do partial differential equations in this class. And so what we're going to do is just skip the word ordinary differential equations and just say differential equations. So I'll put that in parentheses. We're not going to keep saying the word ordinary differential equations. So let's get into some notation. We're going to be taking a whole lot of derivatives. So these are derivative notation. So who is in Calc 4? This quarter, or has taken it in the past. All right, so let's go no Calc 4. Don't be ashamed, it's okay. All right, so well, I'll probably teach you the notation of the big D derivative operator then before you learn it in Calc 4. Well, for us it won't be very exciting. So let's start out with the notation that you're used to. So if y equals f of x, what are the 10,000 ways we can write y derivative? So we can write y prime, which is f prime of x. We can also write it as ddx f of x. You can write it as df dx of x. So these are getting a little bit more exotic as we go. And it could also be written as big D f of x. And you could write it as capital D with a partial derivative type notation right there to mean derivative with respect to x. And if we look at y double prime, of course, this f double prime of x. Seen that one before. That is d dx d dx f of x. You could also write this as d squared over dx squared. And the reason that this is, when you see dx squared, this is never going to be d x squared. It's one whole unit. So you treat it as one whole unit. So when you square it, it's going to be dx dx like that. So it's one whole unit. Kind of like how you can't separate sin in the sine function. You can't just take out the I and do something like that. All right, so this is one whole unit right here. So that's why I don't need parentheses around the dx down there. So I don't need to do that. All right, and that's f x equals, so you could go capital D fx, but of course, if you're going to apply d twice, just write d squared. And it's not generally the best idea to mix superscripts and subscripts, but sometimes you need to. We're not going to use this partial derivative notation much because our derivatives, you're going to know what variable they're going to be with respect to. So we are frequently just going to write capital D or just primes all over the place because they'll all be with respect to the same variable. All right, so there's some new notation. So a more precise definition of ordinary differential equation. So sometimes we'll write ordinary differential equations as ODE. If you're going to abbreviate, write ODE, don't just write DE. Yeah, I've never seen DE used as an abbreviation, so go with ODE. And of course, you have partial differential equations, PDE. Those are standard abbreviations. So definition of ordinary differential equation. We'll let fx go from some interval of the real numbers into R. So you're going to see capital I in this textbook is used for intervals of real numbers. So that's how we're using capital I this quarter. So we have a function that goes from some interval to the real numbers and an ODE. Relates x and f of x and or one or more derivatives of f of x. Well, I do need to write the word one or more. So when I say more derivatives, what I mean is you could have f of x, or f prime of x, f double prime of x, f triple prime of x, et cetera, et cetera. So when I write f prime of x or double prime of x, these are all x derivatives right here. Now if you don't have any derivatives, you probably shouldn't be calling it a differential equation. You just call it an equation relating f and x. You probably wouldn't use the word differential. So that's why we say one or more derivatives. If you got zero derivatives, it's a bit silly to call it a differential equation. So we'll look at some examples of ODEs. So our first example is a differential equation because it has a derivative at least one derivative in an equation. So it's a differential equation. Whenever you see y prime, you can always write y as f of x, so that makes y prime f prime of x. You may need to switch notation depending on what you're trying to do. And I think we can, yeah, let's try to solve these. So we'll write our guessed solution, or hypothesized solution. All right, we have y prime plus y equals 0. This is equivalent to y prime equals negative y. So I just did some algebra, subtracted y to the other side. What function do you know, or can you think of, that has a derivative as negative itself? So y prime would equal negative y. Almost. I think that would be if your fourth derivative. Second derivative? Yeah, that won't quite work here. You gotta think a little outside the box. Most functions, when you take their derivative, they don't become negative. So an exponential function doesn't change much when you take a derivative, so it's almost itself. And if we carefully think about the chain rule, how can we make an exponential function have a derivative of negative itself?
E to the negative x.
So we can go e to the negative x. Derivative will be negative e to the negative x. And we can see right here, if we add y and y prime together, we'll get 0. So I don't expect you to be able to guess these off the top of your head. I'm asking questions that are way less easy when we're going to try to guess solutions. All right, any other ideas? Another choice for y? All right, what about y equals 0? What is y prime? 0. What do you get when you add y and y prime? 0. Sort of unsatisfying, but it's a solution. So there's another solution. All right, that will be enough for one. We don't have to sit here and try to guess every single possibility. We'll just guess the first one or two that come to mind and move on. If you think of another one, go ahead and shout it out. Number two. Y prime equals e to the x. So it's definitely an equation. Is this a differential equation? Got a derivative in it, and it's an equation. And there's no partial derivative, so it's just y prime equals e to the x. All right, solution. Let's guess a y. What function has a derivative e to the x?
Yes.
E to the x, very good. Is that the only function whose derivative is e to the x? This is calc 1 question. There's infinite functions whose derivative is e to the x. That'll work too. So what if we tried? Let's go ax plus b. What's the derivative of this y right here? So it's almost e to the ax plus b.
A e to the
times the extra a, right? From the chain rule. So how do I get rid of the a? Right there. So this y will also work. as long as a is not zero, obviously you have some problems. But if a is not zero, anything of this form will work. We're not going to sit here and try to guess the most general possible form, but this will be good enough. And I think that'll take care of our first. So our first one is a equals 1 and b equals 0, just looking up there. And the second one will be a equals negative 1, right there. So those two are taken care of with our third form down here. So this looks like a far better, or a far more general solution right there. So we'll just keep this guy circled. And of course, a not 0. All right, third. And that cheap solution to problem 1 definitely won't work for problem 2. Y equals 0, if you try that, y prime is definitely not e to the x. So that's not going to work at all. Oh, that second one doesn't work. Yeah, a lot of these don't work, actually. What's the derivative of e to the negative x? So it'll be e to the negative x. So that'll be out. So yeah.
Way to go, Jacob.
So this won't work unless a is 1. So because, yeah, there's no constant in front of the x, that narrows it down quite a bit. I think we can go e to the x plus b, I think is the most general we can go looking here. X plus b. Wait, we can't do that plus b there. Yeah, we got to do it down on the bottom. There we go. So now that plus b disappears on your derivative. And the derivative is just e to the x, not e to the function of x. So all these are junk down here for this problem. So we got there, y prime equals e to the x. So that's our solution. All right, number 3. So this is a differential equation because it has x and a y prime in it. So this will be a differential equation. So this one's going to be more difficult to solve. So we got to think about it because we need to figure out. We could solve for y or y prime pretty easily by either dividing by x or dividing by 2. That might give us a little more intuition. And remember, you can always do algebra whenever you want, as long as you do it correctly. So if I solve for y prime, I'll have 2y over x. And if I solve for regular y, divide by 2, I have 1/2 xy prime. All right, let's try the worst solution. What is derivative? So if y is 0, what's y prime? 0. And if you plug in 0 for y prime and 0 for y, you get 0 equals 0, and everybody's happy. Well, unsatisfied, but literally satisfied, but not emotionally satisfied. So it works, satisfies the equation. There is a non-trivial solution. Oh, yeah. They'll be trig. They'll be complex numbers. All right. So looking at this first relationship, so the derivative is similar to the original, except you multiply it by an x. So it basically lost the power of x. So you can see that from this first line right here. If we look at this third line, so how is your derivative related to y? You have to multiply it by an x, so it's missing an x, and it's twice as big, so you multiply it by 1/2. So what type of function loses an x and gets twice as big when you take a derivative? So we'll try x squared. So x squared will get doubled when you take a derivative and loses an x. It might be better to think depending on how your intuition works, it may be better to think of the top one versus the third one. So the top one says your function, 2 times your original function is equal to the derivative with an extra x. So that might be a better way of thinking of it rather than the third version down here. It just depends on the way your brain thinks about equations. That's why it's good to do a little algebra, change it around. So we'll try x squared, y prime, 2x. And if we plug this in carefully, it doesn't matter which one you plug into, but I do recommend that go to the original in case the algebra I did was very trivial. But in case I made a mistake, I recommend go to the original and plug in your what you think is your solution in the original. So we'll go with x, check x, y prime, which is 2x, equals 2 times y, which is x squared, and we get 2x squared equals 2x squared. So there we go. There's probably going to be other solutions, but this is good enough for now. I just want to get one solution that isn't trivial, that works. Yeah, I think you could put, so if we put a C in front, we'll get a C there. And, yep, we'll get a basically a C and a C, and they'll both cancel out. So yeah, we can take any constant multiple of this particular function. Sometimes you saw we can add a constant. Sometimes we can multiply by a constant. It all depends on your differential equation. Don't assume you can just add a C. In your process, when you integrate, you always add a C. But you saw on the first example we did that C, adding a C, turned into multiplication when we actually solved by taking the natural log. Or I should say the exponential. Yeah, we took the natural log inverse function. All right, last one. And this one should be the most tricky. So but don't just shout the answer out. Take a minute. So we have y double prime minus 2y prime plus y equals 0. So now you have to think of two derivatives at the same time and adding them plus the original function together in this way and getting to 0. All right, ideas.
0, 0, 0.
0 works. 0 satisfies the equation. 0 prime equals 0, y double prime equals 0, and that works. But let's find one that's not trivial. So just looking at this, it looks like polynomials probably won't be a great idea, because you're going to lose a power every derivative, and you're going to have an x hanging around, or some power of x not going to cancel out. So I think polynomials are out. We could try trig functions. What if we just go sine, see what we get? Y prime equals cos x, y double prime equals negative sine x. So I think your y double prime plus y will cancel out, but your y prime is going to be left over. So that's not going to work. You'll have a similar problem if you go cosine. You'll have your middle term. It won't cancel with anything else. Any other guesses? Let's try e to the x. You're going to find that that's very popular overall. E to the x comes up over and over again, and we'll see why in a little bit. So e to the x y prime equals e to the x, y double prime equals e to the x. So add up y and y double prime, you got 2 e to the x minus 2 y primes will add up to 0. So this works. And we could figure out some other ones. Oh. What is that?
Sine x minus cosine x.
Cos x, so that means y prime will be cos plus sine. Is that right? Cos plus sine, so y double prime will be negative sine. Well, let's write it as cos. Cos minus sine. Oh no. It's a good try though. All right. So. All right, the other trig functions probably won't be great because their derivatives sort of get bigger as you go and they're most likely not gonna cancel unless you get super lucky and some trig identity works out and all that. All right, so we're generally not gonna be guessing answers, we're going to be systematically finding them by techniques we're going to learn. But at first, what we're going to be doing is seeing, is this a solution to this differential equation? So is this y a solution? So that's that process we just did is what you're going to do at first to see, are these solutions, are they not? And that's an important skill because as you figure out your own solution, you want to be able to check it. So you want to take your derivatives, plug it back in. Is your differential equation satisfied or not satisfied? So the idea of checking answers is going to be very useful. So the next definition is the order of an ODE. So sometimes it might be called degree, but the order of an ODE is, so what are we going to count? In polynomials, we counted exponents. The highest exponent was our degree in a polynomial. We're going to do something similar here, except we're not really worried about polynomials. We're worried about how many derivatives have you taken. So it's just the maximum number of derivatives that are there. Well, that's phrased poorly. The order of the highest derivative involved. So this one is a little tricky. Is this degree 1 or degree 2? So this one will actually be degree 1 because your second derivatives are going to cancel themselves out. So this will be first degree. Oh, I should write first order. If you have a zero order, you don't have a differential equation. You got a regular equation. So if your highest derivative is a zero derivative, you're just dealing with an algebra problem. So we've been talking about solutions. We were guessing them before. Your book uses log to equal ln.
I noticed that. It's kind of weird.
Is that so? When they write out log, I think they mean the natural base.
Yeah, because the first one that you solved, they did in the book, and they solved it with log, and there was no base to anything. And then the way you solved it was after log.
Yeah. So in this book and in this class, we're going to go with their notation. So if you just see log of x. What that really means now in this book is log base e of x, which is going to be a little weird. What did, if you just saw log before, if you saw log of x, what base would that be? Yeah, log 10. So I just want to warn you, I'll put little jagged lines around that. So before, it was base 10. In this book, it means base e. Won't really make a big deal until at the very end, when if you actually want to get a number out of it. You can just write log and not worry about it like your book until the very last step, pretty much. And I think, yeah, if you're typing in a web work, log means log base 10. So we're going to test, are these solutions or are these not? So this is going to be a relatively complicated differential equation. Given x squared y double prime plus 2xy prime plus y equals ln x plus 3x plus 1. And this is x greater than 0, which is a solution. So first one, we'll try y equals x log x. And two, we'll try y equals x plus log x. So when we write log x, what is the derivative of log x?
1 over x.
That'll be 1 over x. Not 1 over x times ln 10 or divided by ln 10, which is what the base 10 would be. So if it's not base e, it has, I forget if it's divided by or times, but one of those two. All right, how do you check if this first y is a solution? Take derivative, take the next derivative, and plug it in. So go ahead and do that right now. Get first derivative and second derivative and plug it in. And I'm actually going to slide down the second answer, so we have a lot more room. Ooh, I wrote ln x, but obviously I mean log x. All right, not equal. How can I say not equal without simplifying more?
There's no constants.
There's no 1 on the left side. We got the 3x. We got x plus 2x, so we're close. The log x, we don't quite have a log x either. Yeah. So, not equal. You can keep simplifying down and see if you can get all the way down to like 0 equals 0 or something obvious equals itself. All right, we will try other y, which is x plus log x. What would you rather I do, write ln x or log x? Let's go with ln x. Yeah, let's write ln x then. Okay, so time to go. I want you to check this for homework. It should be pretty easy. No product rule going on. This will be way easier than the last one.